why does the universe exist? That is a question that has been bothering people for as long as we have a record of people asking philosophical questions. If you think you live in an eternal universe, maybe you can say, well, it always existed, so we don't have to explain why the universe exists. On the other hand, if you live in a universe that appears to have a beginning, this question becomes somewhat more pressing. What caused this universe to come into existence at that very moment? The Big Bang theory brings this question of contingency. Why does something exist rather than nothing, just back into the forefront in a way that it hasn't been really since the Middle Ages? My name is Karin Öberg, and I'm a professor of astronomy at Harvard University. The scientific question that drives my research is really understanding something both about our own origins, so how we ended up on this beautiful planet in the first place, but also to start getting some constraints on how likely we are to find life elsewhere in the universe. If I were to dream what the next few decades would hold, it would be that we would find some extraterrestrial bacteria somewhere. That would make me extremely happy. I have a father who was very interested in these kind of questions and different scientific questions, but especially in astronomy and cosmology. So I started thinking about, well, simplistic versions of these questions when I was rather young. I read Stephen Hawking's A Brief History of Time when I was a little bit older, maybe 10, 11, 12, and thought it was fascinating. When I think about the scientific project, I think about it as an adventure. And I think even looking back in time, just seeing the truths about the world unfold over time and humanity with our very limited capabilities and senses, just getting a little bit closer in every generation to what the cosmos is actually like, is just an amazing thing to be aware of and to study. If we go back to the ancient East, we have a cosmos that you would recognize from Genesis, where you have sort of small, flat Earth, and then you have an abode above and an underworld. If we fast forward maybe 1,000 years or so to the ancient Greeks, we have a new kind of cosmos that's now centered on the Earth, and the Earth is a globe. In the early modern periods, now we're talking 16th, 17th century, we came to realize that the Earth orbited the Sun. Names like Copernicus, Galileo, Kepler, and so on come to mind. This new heliocentric cosmos was a centerpiece of the Enlightenment cosmology. And they really imagined the whole universe as a clock that's been just wound up, a universe that continues on in perpetuity, both backwards and forwards. This is the setting about 100 years ago that we're just taking for granted that the universe has always been around and been looking the same way. And then two things happen. One was that Einstein presented his theory of relativity, which seemed to suggest that the universe was a bit more unstable. This was something that Einstein himself found very disturbing and he tried to fix. But it took the genius of this physicist priest, Father Georges Lemaître, to realize that no, the universe isn't static, it does change over time. And what Lemaître then realized is that if now the universe is expanding, and there were astronomical observations that suggested that was the case, then if you go back in time, you go to something that is very, very small. What we're talking about is the very rapid expansion of the whole of the universe out of something so incredibly small that we couldn't see it with a microscope into this vast space that we now live in. The Big Bang cosmology is very different from any of the previous cosmologies that humans have imagined they lived in. We live in a universe that evolves and changes over time. We live in a historical universe, is one of the key features. The Big Bang cosmology also tells us that we live in a universe that's ordered, that we can predict how stars and planets form. As far as we can tell, the laws of physics that apply here on Earth also apply 13 billion years ago and billions of light years away in the universe. So it's a universe that is extremely well ordered, where the same laws of physics apply wherever we look. And that's not something you can take for granted. This is the universe that is changing in dramatic ways, and at the same time, it remains constant in the laws that are governing it. So we have this combination of a historical evolving universe that changes over time, that changes in an extremely ordered way, that still has many mysteries left in it, and that also just keeps throwing surprises at us. You can imagine that the Big Bang that got our universe going is just one in a long chain of Big Bangs that have created and destroyed previous universes. You can imagine, and many have, that we live in this sort of superstructure where our universe is a little bubble on this big super universe. There's also, of course, the possibility, and maybe the more straightforward intuition, that the Big Bang is showing us that we live in a universe that had a beginning. The science of the Big Bang theory doesn't show you which one is true. All it can tell us is about the universe we actually live in. However, I do think that the Big Bang provides the best image that we can possibly think of what religious people mean when they talk about creation out of nothing. The universe just offers the most fascinating and difficult and interesting puzzles that you could possibly imagine. And getting to be part of laying that puzzle and fitting the pieces together is something that just brings me joy. But the more fundamental thing is that I really enjoy getting to be part in bringing us a little bit closer to what the universe is actually like. I have a hope that by understanding the creation as well as I possibly can, I will also catch a glimpse of whomever created it in the first place.